Hello everyone. Today we will learn Unit 7, that is Mastering Windows Form, and in that unit our topic is inside printing controls. We have multiple printing controls, but in this lecture we will see the main printing control, which is nothing but a page setup dialog control. It is used to mainly for setting a page. I am your instructor Kruti Patel from LG Institutes of Engineering and Technology. So we will start. First of all, what is page setup dialog control? The page setup dialog control box is used for modify the page settings and printer settings informations for a given document. The user can enable a sections of the dialog box to manipulate the printing and margins, paper orientations, size and source, and to show help and network buttons. The min margin property defines the minimum margins a user can select. Same way, you can also select the max margin property. Next, when you create an instance of the page setup dialog class, the read write properties are set to initial values. For a list of these values, see the page setup dialog constructor. Now I'll show you these are the properties of page setup dialog. First property will be allow margins. It is used to get or set because it is read only as well as write only property, and it is also used with read write properties. So this property is used for get and set a value which indicating whether the margin sections of dialog box is enabled. Next is allow orientation. It is used to get and sets a value indicating whether the orientation section of the dialog box landscape versus portrait is enabled. Next is allow paper, which is used to get or set some value indicating whether the paper section of the dialog box, paper size and paper source is enabled. Next is allow printer, which gets or sets the value indicating whether the printer button is enabled. Next is can raise event, gets a value which indicating whether the component can raise an event or not. It is inherited form component. Next property is container, which gets a I container that contains the component, which is also inherited form component. Last one is design mode, which gets a value that indicates whether the component is currently in design mode. So here it is also an inherited component. Next, these are the methods of our printing controls. So here for page setup control, first method is create object reference type. So its abbreviation is create OBJREF. It is used to create an object that contains all the relevant informations required to generate a proxy used to communicate with the remote object. Next is dispose, which releases all resources used by the component, which is inherited from component. Third one is dispose, which is boolean property, means its value is either 0 or 1, which releases the unmanaged resources by the component and optionally release the managed resources. Next method is equals, which is very important method of this class, which determines whether the specified object is equal to any current object or not. Next method is get hash code. It is a built-in method which is available in all classes of visualc#.net, which serves as the default hash function. Last method is get lifetime service, which retrieves the current service object that contains controls for the lifetime policy of the instance, which is inherited from Marshall by ref object, Now, this much methods and these previous properties are used in this class. Now, we will see practical demonstration of page setup dialog. For it, I'll open Visual Studio. Here, I have taken this project, which is of Windows form, which I have selected from here. I'll show you File, New, Project, and you can select here Visual C Sharp. And other suggested languages are also mentioned here, but I'll select Visual C Sharp, and in Visual C Sharp, Windows is available. And here you can select Windows Form Application. In such way, I have taken this Windows Form Application, which is named as Printing Controls. And here I have created Form 2 for this our control. So I'll close this Form 1. And in program1.cs file, I'll make application.run new form 2. Here you can see I have changed here number to whatever the form. If you have multiple forms or single applications, so you can choose any of the form as a run environment. So I have selected this our form 2. Now I'll show you the components of form 2. First is our control. It is nothing but page setup dialog. So it is dragged from toolbox. So page setup dialog is drag and drop in form 2. So here it is named page setup dialog 1. Next is print document, because in page setup we need to show whatever the document is set in the page setup. And third one is print preview dialog, which is used as a compatible with these two dialogs. Now I have taken this rich text box 1 and this button, which is dragged from toolbox. Now when I clicked on this button, I have written this code, which I'll explain you. You can see here, first of all, I have written page setup dialog 1 dot printer settings. Means what? It will set with two types of settings. First is for printer and second is for page settings. So first I'll assign in dialog as a default settings of our print document. So page setup dialog 1 dot, these both are the initial value. So it is also called initialization of this both settings, printer as well as page. So page setup dialog 1 dot printer settings equals to print document 1 dot printer settings. So whatever the settings which is applied for document, it is passed as a page setup dialog initially. Same way page settings are also passed. So page settings equals to print document 1 dot default page settings. Now it is very important line. If our page setup dialog will be shown in your screen. So page setup dialog 1 dot show dialog method is here. So round bracket open close and equals to dialog result dot OK. Means the dialog will be shown in your screen, and if you will do any settings from this dialog, and when you clicked OK, then and only this task should be accomplished. Means what? If you clicked on cancel, so no reaction should be done there. So it is only affected when you clicked on OK. So when you clicked OK, then the both settings, these both lines are written reversibly. So here you can see here. So whatever the our document settings are assigned in page setup, so it will be in reverse. So page setup or printer settings as well as page settings are assigned to our documents. So here these both lines are written here, which is nothing but the just reverse line of these two lines. Next is print preview dialog 1 dot document equals to print document 1. Here is the mystery. What is print document 1? So here you can see I have dragged this print document 1 component also. As it is a functionality, when you drag this component in our form 2, it will be showing below of the form. I'll show you how it is happening. So first of all, I'll delete print document 1. I'll find these all printing controls here, and again I'll drag print document 1 and drop here. So you can see I dropped in form 2, but it will be here. placed here. So print document one is a functionality, in fact all printing controls. So these are displayed in this below window of form 2. Now this print document's print page event is called first. First of all, we will see what is print document, then we will see this line, what it will tell you. Now, first in right click, by right clicking on this print page document, in property window will be shown you, in event, you can call print page event. So here, I called this print page event. I'll copy this code and paste over here. So print preview dialog 1 dot document equals to print document 1. So whatever your document which will be assigned in the print document, it will be passed over here. Now print preview dialog will be shown to you. So it will be shown. So now I'll show you the output. First of all, what task will be happen when you load the form? Form load will first of all show you these two components. First is rich text box and next is button. So when you, if you want to assign the rich text box text, then you need to write this code, which I have written here, this one. So if you want to call this data in print document through, so you need to write font f equals to new font rich text box 1 dot text, this both line which I have explained you in prior my lecture, which is of print document 1. So these both two lines should be written here, and then after your document is assigned as a print preview dialog 1, and this dialog will be shown to you. Here I have not written this font class, so it will not display you, but you can write. Next is when you click button, this data will be shown to you here. So dialog will be shown, whatever the settings you will selected, this is saved in this window. So I'll run this form 2. Here you can see as an output form 2 is here, whatever the text, but it will not affect as I have not written font class with rich text box. So when I clicked on button, you can see here, I'll magnify the screen. Page setup dialog is displayed to you. In that you can do this type of settings. First you can say resize its size. You can select any of the size, A3, A4, A5, whatever the size you want. You can also select its source, and you can also change its orientation, which is portrait or landscape. Then after, you can also set its margin, which is nothing but the left, right, top and bottom margins are here. So in such kind of settings are done through this page setup dialog. So it is nothing but a code which is used to use a page setup dialog in Visual C#. Thank you, everyone.